Hello, my lovely friends. My name is Ava, and these are some romance books that have scarred characters in them. So these are romance books where one of the people or both of the people in the couple are scarred or have some sort of physical scar on them, whatever the case may be. First, we have Again the Magic by Lisa Kleypas. This is, of course, a historical romance book, and it was done so well. This is about Lady Aline and McKenna. Yes, McKenna. And when they were younger, they had this beautiful love affair, like when they were like teenagers. However, McKenna is like, I think like a stable boy. Aline is a very high lady in society, and her dad figures out about their romance, and he basically tells Aline to get rid of him or he will kill him. And so Aline basically tells McKenna that she doesn't love him, like she makes up all these lies so that she can save him. And McKenna thinks that she's telling the truth, and he leaves. It's been years later. McKenna is now back in England. He went to America and made a man for himself. He's now rich. He's basically back to torment Aline and to get back at her for what she did to him. Little does he know that after that time, after she sent him away, she was in an accident and was severely burned on her legs, and she's very self-conscious of it and doesn't believe that even if she were to like apologize to him and explain what happened, she doesn't think that anybody could love her because of what her body looks like now. Boy, does he prove her wrong. He proves her wrong. It takes a while for him to get there, obviously, because she basically broke his heart. But man, this book is so well done. I get why this is so many people's favorite books ever, because it was beautiful, and I just love how McKenna was able to show Aline that she is beautiful, scars and all. Oh, beautiful, amazing. Next, I have My Darling Duke by Stacey Reed. This is about Kitty Danvers. Basically, she's in a little bit of a bind because she is the oldest out of a bunch of sisters, and in this society, like, basically the younger sisters can't get married unless the older sister has, like the oldest one. And so she just knows she's not gonna get married. So she makes up this ruse and this lie that she is engaged to the Duke of Thornton, who is Alexander. In here, she just knows that he's a recluse and he never comes out in society, and so he could never know that she made up this rumor that they're engaged. She does this to make sure that her sisters are able to go out into the ton, into society, and find matches and fall in love. But then Alexander, the Duke, gets a whiff of this and is like, who is this woman making up lies about me? Like, we're not engaged. What is going on? And so he goes out into society and finds her and meets her and realizes that he's kind of like a little bit infatuated with her, and it's like, you know what, I'll let you continue this ruse for now. We'll see what happens. And so they end up I think like getting trapped one night in like a cabin in the middle of nowhere, and they start to fall in love with one another during their like forced proximity situation here. The hero is the scarred character in this situation. I believe he has a scar on his face. I don't remember why, but the hero is also wheelchair bound. He has been told he will never have full function of his legs again. I believe he does use his crutches also at some point, but he does have a scar along his face. And oh, this book was just done so well. I love Stacey Reed. I need to read more of her books, and I can't wait to read the next book in this series as well. Okay, the last historical romance that I have is The Duchess Steele by Tessa Dare, the first book in the Girl Meets Duke series. Here is the very pretty step back here for you. Man, this was one of the first historical romances that I ever read, and it set the bar really high, y'all. This is about the Duke of Ashbury, and he went off to war, and when he came back, his fiance that he had called things off because he was severely scarred during battle, and she's like, I could never marry you because you look like that. And so Emma, who was the dressmaker for her wedding, comes to his house wearing the wedding dress and being like, I demand you pay me for the hard work that I've done. Look, see all the hard work that I've done on this dress. You have to pay me for it, even if she's not gonna wear it. Like, I need to be paid for it. And he sees her in this wedding dress and is like, I have an idea. What if we get married because I need an heir, and basically I only have you as a wife in order to produce that heir, and then you don't have to see me ever again. She agrees to this, but she also has some rules of her own that she is requiring him to fulfill, to do, and this grumpy, gruff, damaged hero ends up falling in love with this woman. And it's so good. He is, of course, very jaded and heartbroken, has a lot of PTSD when it comes to women and how he looks because of what his previous fiance did to him and what she said to him, because that can be traumatic. Like, that is horrible. And so he doesn't think that she could ever, that Emma could ever love him because of the way that he looks, and she proves him wrong. She definitely proves him wrong. Next, I have That Kind of Guy by Talia Hibbert. This is a friends to lovers romance between Ray and Zach. Zach is actually younger than Ray, so the heroine is a little bit older than the hero in this one. And they decide to fake date one another for this writer's convention because Ray's ex-husband is going to be there. She kind of wants to show him up because he cheated on her. And through them doing this fake relationship thing here, they start to fall in love with one another. Ray has my chronic illness called POTS, or postural orthostatic tachycardia syndrome. Basically, we faint a lot. And so she actually has a scar on her face from one of her episodes, and so she fainted one day and she knocked into some glass and the glass cut her cheek, and so she has a scar on her face now from one of her episodes. That's honestly really scary because I have fallen in places I probably shouldn't have, but I've also fallen on my bed and like fainted on my bed on the floor and stuff like that, so like I get that, but it's really scary. I get her feelings and being scared, and whenever you faint you have no control of what happens to your body or what happens to you or what you fall into, and it can be really scary at points. And so I really related to her in that. This was just one really well, and if you want to learn more about my chronic illness, read this one. Oh, also I want to mention Talia Hibbert herself also has POTS, so its own voices as well. Next I have Enticed by the Corsair by Ruby Dixon. This is the third book in the Corsair series. This is an alien romance series all about space pirates. So at the beginning of book one, you have four alien dudes who look very similar to the guys from the Ice Planet Barbarian series. They are space pirates and they commandeer things on their pirate spaceship. And it's just the four of them. And then each book is about one of them falling in love with a human woman, and they end up bringing them onto the spaceship, and it gets even more crowded as each one of them falls in love. So this one, the characters end up commandeering this spaceship filled with just bad aliens. Like, they're bad, they're evil, they're grotesque, they're bad. While they're searching the ship, looking what to commandeer, they come across this room full of body parts. Like, it's grotesque, disgusting, and they think everyone in there is dead. And then they come across this cage in this room where there is one survivor, a human woman who has her eyes cut out of her head. She is now blind. She has scars all around her face and her eyes because they basically just took her eyeballs out. A little grotesque, obviously, and a little bit graphic, so please beware. And so this book is about her dealing with being blind and her navigating the world, or technically the spaceship that they're on, blind, and learning how to be blind. And the hero in here is one of those space pirates, and from the first moment that he sees her, he is just smitten with her and thinks that she is beautiful and brave and strong and just, oh, amazing. He swoons over this woman and will do anything for her, and beautiful. It was amazing. I have another Ruby Dixon book for you. We have Fire in His Chaos. This is a book number 8 in the Fireblood Dragon series. So this series is all about dragon shifters, and it's a post-apocalyptic Earth setting. So one day a rift opened up in the sky and dragons started flying out and decimating the Earth, and there are only a few survivors. Our heroine here, named Rachel, is one of those survivors. The day that the dragons did come, she ended up, I think she, a house collapsed on her, I want to say, or something collapsed on her, and she is now an amputee. She does not have part of her arm, and her face is severely scarred from it too. She had some tissue damage in her face because that whole incident is years later. She is still living on Earth with the survivors of this apocalypse, basically. And this is about a dragon shifter finding her and then becoming mates, and him just falling in love with her. These books are very formulaic, obviously, in this series, but I just can't help but love them and think they are so entertaining. I really loved this one specifically, just because Rachel and the hero in here, I can't remember his name, it's an alien dragon name, whatever. I love them. They were great. They're one of my favorite couples in the series, and I can't wait for the last book in the series to come out as well. I then have a fantasy romance for you, which is Heart of the Fae by Emma Hamm. This is a Beauty and the Beast retelling dealing with Fae, obviously. This is about Sorsha, and she is a midwife But her father is sick with a plague that is raving her little town, and so she goes in search of a witch, and this witch tells her, "I will give you the cure to this illness if you go across the sea and find this prince for me." This outcasted prince. He has been outcasted by his people. That is our hero of this story. He is the beast character of this story, and he used to be a fey prince, was going to be king one day. He got in a fight with his brother one day. He ends up being cut by his sword. And if you can see, I don't know if you can really see, but there's all these jagged cuts on him, the scars on him, and geodes started like growing out of his body. And fae are very much known for wanting to be perfect, pristine, beautiful. Once this happens to him, everyone is disgusted by him, and he gets casted out of his fae land. And so now he is the ruler of this kind of like misfit island filled with a bunch of people who were also banished from fae land. And so Sorsha goes to this land in search of this prince, to hopefully save her father's life. This is a great spin on Beauty and the Beast, by the way, and I love Beauty and the Beast retellings, and I feel like this was done super well. And there's also a companion book to it too if you want to read that, but I just love this. I love this. Oh, beautiful. Hello my friends, this is Editing Avery here. The whole rest of this video is off sync with the audio. I'm having some camera issues. Hopefully it's fine right now. But yeah, the last three books in this video I have to refilm the footage for it because the audio is not on sync with the actual footage. So let's talk about the last three books. Okay, we're gonna talk about November 9 by Colleen Hoover. I'm not gonna talk too much about this book because I feel like anything that I say about this could be spoilery, so I'm gonna keep it very vague, and I recommend doing that. I don't recommend knowing a lot about this book before you go into it because it was such a joy to read not knowing a lot because there's a bunch of twists and turns and everything. And so this is about Fallon and Ben, and Fallon and Ben met one day, I believe at a restaurant or a coffee shop or somewhere. They met one day there and they agree to meet that day, November 9th, only on that day every year, in the same spot, I'm pretty sure. And so Fallon in here is the one who has scars. She was in a very horrible house fire and her face and I believe most of her body is pretty severely burned. I don't want to talk too much or say anything else about this because anything else could be very spoilery, so I'm not gonna say anything else. But I did really enjoy this one, and if you like Colleen Hoover, here you go. Next, I have Dark Sky by Cressley Cole. This is book number 14 in the Immortals After Dark series, and I really recommend reading this series in order, but you don't necessarily have to. If you are going to read this book, I recommend reading the heroine in this book, her sister's book, before this one, because you learn about the heroine and Dark Sky in that book. Anyway, our heroine in here, her name is Ianthe, and she is a sorceress, and she has these magical powers, and basically she, whenever she says a command to somebody, like, that person has to do it. Like, that's her, like, power, to command people to do stuff. And so when she's a child, she ends up across Thronos, or Thronos comes across her, and he's this type of mythical being or magical being, I can't remember the name, but he basically looks like an angel. He has, like, wings and everything like that. And so when he's a kid, he like knows that Ianthe is his mate. But something happens to where Ianthe believes that Thronos betrayed her, and so she commands him as a little boy to jump out of a window and to not use his wings. And so by doing that, he falls out of the window and his wings are completely shattered and scarred and almost unusable, basically. And since this happened before Thronos turned into an immortal, his wings will be like that for the rest of his life, basically. And so it is years and centuries later, and Thronos has been trying to find Ianthe for years to try and get her back for what happened to him. And he knows that even though that is his mate, he still needs to have her seek retribution, you know, like he needs to seek justice for what this woman did to him. And so it's kind of like an enemies to lovers kidnapping situation here, and I really like this one in the series. I know that not a lot of people do, but I did. Oh, it was so good, so good. And the last book on this list is Stay With Me by Jay Lynn, or technically Jennifer L. Armentrout. This is the third book in the Wait For You series. This is also a college romance. This is about Kala and Jax. Kala is the one who has a scar on her face, and she's 21. She goes to college. She is really embarrassed and self-conscious about her scar on her face, so she covers it up every single day with makeup, like packs it on there. She ends up getting a job, I believe, at the same bar that Jax is at, and by them meeting and becoming friends, Kala is forced to let down her walls and she is struggling with that, and struggling to confront her past and what she has gone through previously and the reasoning behind her scar and everything. So this one is a little emotional, but I think it's really good. I feel like it's one of my favorite in that Wait For You series by Jennifer L. Armentrout. If you haven't read that series, check it out, really fun. But yeah, I really enjoy this one as well. So there you have it. Those are some romance books that have scar characters in them. Sorry for the technical difficulties. I love these books so much. They have some of my favorite characters ever. Please leave me some recommendations down in the comment section down below, because I'm always looking for recommendations. But anyways, thank you all so much for watching. I will see y'all soon in my next one. Bye, y'all.